In this video, we will try to understand why Levy flights are used in meta-heuristic optimization algorithm. So here you can see the topics covered in this video. First, we will start with basic concept of Levy flight. What is Levy flight? How Levy flights work? Random walk. What is random walk? How we can generate random numbers using Levy flight, and why we are using Levy flight in meta-heuristic optimization, and how we can use Levy flight in the meta-heuristic optimization algorithm. So here, first we will start with what is Levy flights. Here you can see we have two terms, Levy and flights. Levy term is originated from the name of a French mathematician who first studied Levy motions. Next we have flights. This means maximum straight line distance between two points that an object can cover. So as you can see here, Levy flights are type of random walks where step length follow a heavy-tailed probability distribution. Or in simple words, we can say Levy's flight is a random walk whose step size is derived from Levy's distribution. So it is nothing just the random walk, but here the step size is derived using Levy's distribution. Now we will try to understand how Levy flight work. Here you can see Levy flight, it is a long continuous motion periodically broken by short steps. This is the starting point and here we have the end point. So it is a long continuous motion periodically broken into short steps. So as in real life, when we walk, we take one step after another. So here we have the virtual environment. When we use nature-inspired meta-heuristic algorithms, then here we have the virtual search agents as birds, animals, and other who explore the search space and find out the best solution. So here you can see Levy flight, that is just the random walk, but here it is derived using the Levy's distribution. So as we have the virtual environments, so we simulate different real life behavior for the virtual search agents. Now next we will try to understand how Levy flights work. Here you can see different steps followed here. First, step length generation. Next, we will choose random direction. After that, we will update the current position. So first step we have here, the step length generation. Step length in Levy flight is drawn from the Levy's distribution, and the probability density function of Levy distribution, you can see here, this one here, small x, that is the step length, and beta, you can see here, it is the parameter that determine the heavy-tailedness of the distribution. In the context of Levy's flight, we can choose the value for beta between 1 and 2. After that, we will choose the random direction. So this direction is chosen typically uniformly distributed in the optimization space. After that, we will update the position. The algorithm updates its current position by taking step in the chosen direction with the computed step length. So you can see here the example of Levy's flight with start and the end point. First step is the step length generation. Here, the step length is drawn from the Levy's distribution. You can see here. Here, x is the step length. Then we need the direction, whether it will move down, left, up, down, and in other side. So we will select the random direction. After that, we will update the position. Next, we have random walk. That is a mathematical concept that derives a path, or we can say trajectory, consisting of series of steps taken randomly. Here you can see we have different types of random walk: sequential steps, discrete or continuous random walk, random steps. Then we have Markov property. First we have sequential step. This involves sequence of step taken one after another. Next one we have discrete or continuous random walk. Random walks can be either discrete or continuous. In discrete random walk, the steps are taken at distinct time intervals. And in continuous random walk, the steps are taken continuously. Third one, we have random steps. In random steps, at each step, the direction and the size are determined randomly. That is done often according to the probability distribution. And the last one, we have Markov property. So according to this property, the future steps in the random walk are independent of the past steps. So whatever future steps will be, they are not dependent on the past step that give the current position. Random walks are used to model various phenomena in different fields, including physics, finance, computer science, and other. Here you can see we have two common types of random walk: one dimension random walk and two dimension random walk. In one dimension random walk, the entity moves along a straight line, taking steps to the left or right with equal probability. Next, we have two-dimensional random walk. In two-dimensional random walk, an entity moves on a plane taking steps in different direction. Here, it can move either up, down, left, right with equal probability. You can see these two equations that are used to generate a series of steps in the random walk. Here, Sn, you can see here this one. It is the sum of each consecutive random steps. Xi, that is the random steps, and the value for I we have 1 to n, and this equation can be write as this one. And here you can see in this equation the next state is dependent on the current existing state, that is Sn minus 1. Next we have Levi-Flight step size calculation. Proper step size is important for the random walk, and here step size are frequently used for the randomization and the local search. Proper step size is important for the random walk, and in meta-heuristic optimization algorithm, step size are frequently used for the randomization and local search. In random walk, step size regulate the distance a random walker can travel over a certain number of iterations. If the step size is too large, the new solution generated away from the old solution, and such moves has no chance to be used. And if the step size is too small, it may not have practical importance. It can make search inefficient. That's why the proper step size is important for effective search in the search space. So here you can see Levi-Flight, that is a random walk whose step size is derived from the Levi's distribution. And you can see Levi's distribution integral form. Here this is the sort time interval during each step, alpha, and here you can see alpha. That is a constant which control the scaling of distribution, and it can be any positive value that is often set equal to 1 in the most applications. So this is the Levi distribution given by integral. This can be computed as this one, which is heavy tail, and the value for beta you can see we have here, it should be greater than 0 and less than 2. Next we have the implementation of random numbers using Levi-Flight. So here we will generate random numbers using Levi-Flight. So the creation of random numbers using Levi-Flight require two main steps. First, the random direction selection. So first you will select the random direction. After that, the creation of steps that follow the selected Levi distribution. Now first step, you can see here the step size calculation. Here the random direction is drawn from the Levi's distribution that is given here. You can see in this equation, you can see we have value u and v. They are drawn from the normal distribution. Here the distribution follow Levi's distribution. Value for u is calculated using this. Here sigma, that is the standard deviation. Value for v is calculated using this. And value for sigma u is calculated using this equation here. This one, the value for sigma v, we have 1. And here you can see this is the step size and this is the small step size. And the step size should be either greater than or equal to the small step size. In context of optimization algorithm, Levi-Splite are used to introduce the randomness and long range exploration. Here you can see Levi-Splite from start to end. In meta-heuristic optimization algorithm, this step is beneficial as the tail nature of Levi-Splite allow for continuous long jumps. You can see here, continuous long jumps, which is beneficial for the global exploration. The long jump enable the algorithm to explore the solution space more widely and escape local optima. So in meta-heuristic optimization algorithm, Levi-Splites are often integrated into search process to balance exploration and exploitation phases. So here you can see the steps how Levi-Splite can be used for any meta-heuristic optimization algorithm. First, you will initialize the population for the solution randomly in the search space. After that, we will repeat the loop for each solution in the population, generate Levi-Splite step. After that, update the solution position using Levi-Splite step, and then we will evaluate the solution fitness using objective function. After that, we will update the population based on the evaluation of solution. So Levi-Splite can be effective in certain scenarios. Their application and success depends on the nature of optimization problem and the choice of Levi-Splite parameter, such as scaling factor and the Levi exponent, that is beta, may need to be adjusted based on the characteristics of the problem being solved. So here you can see the benefits of using Levi-Splites in the meta-heuristic. First, we have global exploration within the solution space. It gave us high quality solution and it also enhanced algorithm exploration capability as it avoid solutions stuck in the local optima. In meta-heuristic algorithms, randomization is used to avoid solution being trapped in the local optima, and at the same time, randomization also increases the diversity of the solution. The most efficient way of achieving randomization is random walk. In meta-heuristic algorithm, Levi-Splite is often used for the better results because we have different benefits. It helps us in the global exploration, give us better quality solution. It prevents our solution to stuck in the local optima. So in meta-heuristic algorithms, when search agents such as animals, birds, and other, they are searching optimal solution in the solution space, they explore sometime little or nothing about possible location of resources, and sometimes they stuck in the local optima. So in such situation, Levi-Splite can be used. Levi-Splite provide encounters with limited and randomly distributed targets. So Levi-Splite is used in different meta-heuristic algorithms. So first we have Levi-Splite based particle swarm optimization algorithm, Levi-Splite based cuckoo search algorithm. Here you can see in the cuckoo search algorithm, the Levi-Splite is applied here. Here you can see this beta, that is a constant, is also known as the shape parameter used to control the heaviness of the distribution. Next we have Levi-Splite based Firefly algorithm. In the Firefly algorithm, Levi-Splite is used here to calculate the movement of firefly, movement of any firefly towards the brighter firefly. Here you can see we have the randomness added with the Levi-Splite. We have also Levi-Splite based BAT algorithm. Here you can see for the randomness, Levi-Splite is added so that the agents can explore the more wider search space for the better solution. And then we have Levi-Splite based flower pollination algorithm. So here in the flower pollination, the insects move from one flower to another for the pollinations. So here in this algorithm, Levi-Splite is used to control insect step size over long distance. Here you can see Levi-Splite is added. Like that, we have different Levy-Flight waste algorithm, like Levy-Flight waste artificial weak colony optimization, Levy-Flight waste ant colony optimization, Levy-Flight waste gray wolf optimization algorithm, Levy-Flight waste whale optimization algorithm, Levy-Flight waste moth flame optimization algorithm, and so many algorithms we have used. So as we discussed that the Levy-Flight are the type of random walk where the step size is calculated using the Levy's distribution, and the advantage of using Levy-Flight in the meta heuristic algorithm is during search process we can explore wider area, and as we can explore large range of search space we can find out more better solution, that is the solution having the best quality, and also prevent solution to stuck in the local optima and enhance the algorithm exploration capability. So that's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.